Dave Liebman is what I would call the rabbi.
One, two, three.
And he has this incredible spiritual message that he conveys, both in what he plays, and also he has this incredible talent at speaking about jazz and improvised music in general. Why it's important, what's special about it.
Musically, Dave has always been a big inspiration for me because he's about the truth.
A true artist, someone that takes his craft very, very seriously.
It's just amazing. I've watched him grow in all these different directions, and it's just incredible. He sets his mind to something, and he sets a straight line, and he'll reach whatever he sets his mind to do. Amazing individual.
When we do that, I'm not going to give you the bar numbers because mine are off, I guess. But you want to go ba, 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 one, two, boom. That's heavy.
I suppose the first time I met Dave was possibly at his loft on 19th Street. And I was probably all of 19 and he was something like 22 years old. But I remember hearing him play for the first time and being astounded and blown away. And I remember thinking, well, you know, he's so much older than me that, you know, maybe I'll have time to catch up. You know, because 3 years at that time was a vast expanse. I figured, and I've been trying to catch up ever since.
So you take someone like that, who's being propelled by the continuing spirit of John Coltrane, which is really where he got his start, when he was a teenager and checking in on a live show at Birdland and being totally enamored by the sound of Coltrane's soprano saxophone on the tune My Favorite Things. And you have one of the strongest voices out there for jazz, in both the sense of what he's playing and what he's saying.
Well, Dave is kind of the musical director, I would say, of this sextet.
I definitely want a solo on it. Maybe one more. I don't know. That's what will be figured out. Cecil's is obviously Ravi and Cecil. Your tune is you and what? That has to be figured. Phil's tune is all of us, right? You piano and three horns.
A little bit on piano.
Okay.
I mean, it might be nice for piano solo and Renata.
And Renata?
Yeah, okay. That'd be good. Phil? Good, clear spot.
Okay, Robbie's tune is so we don't know. And Randy, I asked Randy to write something for Michael. I said, we really need a fast tune. So we can spend some time because we need it, you know?
Dave is the kind of leader that lets things happen in the way people are and who they are. So for me, it's a beautiful communication between the three of us, as well as the interaction with the rhythm section. This fantastic rhythm section: Cecil McBee, Billy Hart, and Phil Markowitz. You know.
Immaculate historian, band leader, at the same time, unbelievably underrated.
Yes, yes, Cecil, it's an E.
Yeah,
so I've been playing a G instead of an E, right?
Well, I'm playing it so strong.
Yes, you've covered
it.
That's the heavy note. That's what I'm saying. That E is hit, and that's a low E, and that's boom. You know, that's what that is.
Liebman is
sincere.
is sincerity. Dedication, sincerity. You know?
So we play that major seventh thing. G, G, one, two, boom.
Pretty good musician, too.
I think if he doesn't get a MacArthur grant by the time he's 67, something's wrong with the world. Because he's definitely a genius.
Yeah, it was a good take.
It was played,
man.
Right.
Wasn't a bad take.
It was a good take.
A hard tune, man.
Yeah.
Very hard. Any suggestions? Should we go a little longer? Should there be another chorus by me? Should this exchange thing break down more? I have no ideas.
Alpha Omega, this is my wife Karis' suggestion. I was looking for a title. As you know, my original intention, at least the thought I put out for this recording, was that we would take each take a train tune or a late train tune, and use the tune or an idea from the tune to initiate an original composition. In some cases, as you know, Joe did it, and Ravi did it to some extent, etc. And working on Cosmos, my contribution, at least as far as the late trained repertoire, rearranging Cosmos, I just came up with this tune. This is the kind of harmony that I like to use a lot, you know, my way of thinking. And Alpha Omega, from the beginning to the beginning and the end, Cosmos, and this is where the title comes from. It's meant as a kind of tight harmony kind of thing, with the alto clarinet, soprano, you know, it's just that kind of sound, tenor and high register. A vehicle for expressing the kind of harmony that I often like to play, that, you know, something I've been exploring for so long. Cosmos, Alpha, beginning and the end.